If you're going through a dark night of the soul or a spiritual depression, you may be familiar with certain types of feelings of hopelessness. In this video, I'm going to explore different types of feelings of hopelessness, different symptoms of the spiritual depression, of the dark night of the soul. What are the characteristics of this hopelessness, of these very dark, heavy, depressive feelings? And what you can do in order to heal and go through this experience with as little as damage to your life as possible with the maximum amount of wisdom. And so let's get started with this video. So let's explore these different feelings of hopelessness. What are the characteristics of this experience? Well, first of all, we're talking about a painful feeling. This is both a mental and emotional feeling as well as in the body. So when you're going through these dark, heavy feelings of hopelessness, there's usually an unpleasant feeling in the mind as well as in the body. Secondly, there is a time distortion. That means that when you're going through these feelings of helplessness, it will be felt as if that life is always going to be this way. There's this element of time distortion. So it's going to feel like, in those moments, as if it's always been, life has always been horrible and it will continue to be horrible. So even though it's just a momentary feeling, you may be experiencing it for a few minutes, a few hours, or a few days, in those moments of intense feelings of hopelessness, there is going to be some kind of time distortion, meaning you're going to feel as if life is always going to be this horrible. There is this very deep time distortion as part of these feelings of hopelessness. There is a focus on dukkha, and dukkha is in the Buddhist language meaning suffering. So in those moments of hopelessness, you're going to feel very much focused on all the dark and depressive and suffering elements of life, on death, on illness, on things ending, on life being unsatisfying, helplessness. You're going to feel a complete focus of your mind on the depressive or dark parts of life. This is a very strong characteristic of this feeling of helplessness. There's going to be a feeling of low motivation. In those moments of feeling helplessness, you're going to feel low motivation towards taking care of yourself, low motivation towards doing anything. So your motivation, your feeling of internal motivation to do anything is going to be quite low. Addictive patterns may surface, whether you have some kind of cigarette addiction or some kind of drug addiction, alcohol, whatever it may be, eating. Those addictive patterns, they tend to come up more during these times of the dark night of the soul or these feelings of helplessness. So you may begin to notice that in those moments there may be a strong craving for some kind of past addiction that you may have overcome or that may have not surfaced recently. There's going to be anhedonia. Anhedonia means the inability to enjoy the small things in life, the inability to enjoy being with friends, the inability or the inability to see joy or to see happiness in the small and beautiful things in life. And there's usually some kind of self-aversion, some kind of hatred towards the self, some kind of complete lack of self-love. So these are some of the characteristics of these feelings of hopelessness or helplessness that tend to come up during these episodes of the dark night of the soul. And these episodes of the dark night of the soul, they usually follow some kind of spiritual peak, some kind of spiritual high. Maybe you had some beautiful experience on psych, or maybe you had this experience because of some kind of spiritual practice or meditation practice or even yoga practice. But these episodes of feelings of helplessness or hopelessness or the spiritual depression, dark night of the soul, they tend to follow this spiritual peak, some kind of high that you experienced. And then the dark part or the more difficult emotions, they tend to come to the surface. And so what can we do? How can you go through these difficult and painful dark feelings with the maximum amount of wisdom, the maximum amount of healing, and without damaging your life? So we're going to explore that right now. So the first thing to understand is that movement is incredibly important. So moving the body, going for a walk, exercising your body, even though when you're going through some kind of spiritual depression, the dark night of the soul, or feelings of hopelessness, the last thing you want to do is to move. But moving the body, moving the energy, having some kind of exercise, or even just going for a walk, for a short walk, can be extremely and incredibly helpful. So remember that. When you're experiencing some of the dark feelings, Maybe take yourself out of where you are right now and just go for a short or long walk. Try to develop the daily habit of exercising, taking care of your body, even though it's the last thing you want to do when you're feeling low. Exercising your body is going to make you feel amazing. And so remember that, that's the first point. The second point is service. So serving somebody else, helping somebody else, tends to take us out of our own self-centered suffering and into helping another person. So taking care of somebody else, helping somebody else, can really help you to lift this fog, go above this fog of your own feelings of hopelessness and help somebody else. Service can be incredibly helpful when you're going through these dark feelings. So surrendering consciously, that means that we have a tendency when we're going through these painful feelings to be very unconscious. That means we fall back into being completely identified with this suffering person, with this identity or historical identity of a person who is suffering. And this is not very helpful. So suffering consciously and surrendering to that, meaning you are aware of the suffering that's going on within you, whether that is emotional, physical, or mental, but there is a part of you which is transcendent. There is a dimension within you that is just observing this suffering and being conscious of that, but is not completely involved with that. And so surrendering consciously to these feelings and having this attitude, this conscious surrendering attitude, that means giving yourself a few moments or 20 minutes or an hour to just sit, meditate, or lay down and surrender consciously to all these experiences and begin to label. What kind of experience are you going through right now? Is it feelings of hopelessness? Where do you feel it in your body? And what kind of stories are coming up? Begin to label, right now I'm feeling that these feelings of hopelessness are never going to go away. Or it feels like I'm going to feel like this forever. Just label it and begin to surrender consciously to whatever it is that you're experiencing, whether it is pleasant or unpleasant. Embrace. So having some kind of embracing attitude, like you're holding a little baby, holding this suffering and embracing it with some kind of attitude of very, very delicate touch. Imagine as if you're holding a small baby that is crying and you're trying to help this baby to feel better. You wouldn't be pushing this baby and you wouldn't be shaking this baby, you wouldn't be hitting this baby. But we have this tendency when we're feeling low to beat ourselves down even more. And so try to cultivate this attitude of embracing this inner pain, holding it like a small child. This can be very, very helpful for you. Try to listen to the different stories that these feelings of hopelessness are telling you. Begin to listen. What can these feelings teach me? Have this attitude of listening. Try to listen intently and be open to some kind of lesson, some kind of wisdom that may come from these feelings of suffering. You may not notice it in first glance, but this may come later. There can be incredible wisdom. Suffering can be an amazing teacher. So open yourself up and begin to listen. What's actually the stories that this suffering, that these feelings of hopelessness can tell me? Having some kind of dedicated spiritual practice. If you're just suffering, if you're just going through these feelings of hopelessness, thinking they're just going to go away, it's very helpful to have some kind of disciplined, formal spiritual practice, whether that is meditation practice or yoga practice or some kind of spiritual practice that you have learned and you have dedicated yourself to. And so going through these feelings of hopelessness or a dark night of the soul and having some kind of spiritual practice that you do every day can be incredibly helpful and can be the difference between making progress in your path and just having the same experiences again and again and again. And lastly, having some kind of support, whether that is through a teacher or a mentor, somebody who has gone through this before and has passed it, or having even ideally a community of people. Because when you feel like these feelings are just very personal and you feel very alone, and so having some kind of support by a mentor or a community, it helps us to understand and to embrace this understanding that these feelings are our greater human heritage. They are our suffering as opposed to your own individual unique suffering. And so I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want more of my help, you can click some of the links below for scheduling a free session with me, or you can join my free Telegram group or get my free Balance of Mind training, and I'll speak to you soon.